Hello ladies and gentlemen, in this video, we are going to cover the 5 facts about political scenario in Maharashtra regarding government formation. Now first thing first, why it was in news? It was in news because Supreme Court directed today that the floor test in Maharashtra Assembly will be conducted on 27th of November. Now before we talk about Supreme Court verdict, let's understand the entire background story. Elections held in Maharashtra on 21st of October for 288 seats. Now, in order to form government, the political party would need 145 seats to prove its majority. BJP got 105. Again, the numbers are not important, but in order to understand this political game, you need to understand these numbers. Numbers are not important from exam perspective. So, BJP got 105, Shiv Sena got 56, Congress got 44, and NCP got 54. That means, no single party had the numbers to form government. Before elections, BJP and Shiv Sena were alliance. However, after elections, there was some disagreement between Shiv Sena and BJP, and therefore, they did not come together to form government. Now, on 9th of November, Maharashtra Governor Mr. Bhagat Singh Koshyari invited BJP to form government. Now, why BJP was invited? Because BJP is the single largest party, and as per the convention, single largest party is invited. So, BJP was invited. However, BJP said that they don't have the numbers to form government. Subsequently, Governor invited Shiv Sena because Shiv Sena is the second largest party. Shiv Sena claimed that they have numbers to form government and they requested 3 days' time to give the letter of support so that they can form government with the help of Congress and NCP. Now, the Governor declined to accept the request of Shiv Sena. Now, after this, the Governor invited NCP because NCP is third largest party. So, the story so far is that as per the governor, no party was in a position to form the government. Therefore, governor recommended presidential rule. So, President Ramnath Kovind imposed the presidential rule on the recommendation of Maharashtra Governor Mr. Bhagat Singh Koshyari. Maharashtra Governor in his report said that there is no probability of a stable government formation in Maharashtra at the moment. So, presidential rule was imposed in Maharashtra as per the provisions of Article 356. And this was for the first time presidential rule was imposed in Maharashtra on the grounds that no political party was able to form the government. However, in the background, Shiv Sena, Congress and NCP came together as a post-poll alliance. Now, the presidential rule was imposed on 12th of November and on 23rd of November, in morning, the presidential rule was revoked and Mr. Devendra Fadnavis from BJP took oath as the Chief Minister of Maharashtra and Mr. Ajit Pawar from NCP became the Deputy Chief Minister. So this decision was challenged in Supreme Court. Why it was challenged? NCP said that the decision of Mr. Ajit Pawar to join hands with BJP was his personal decision and it was not the decision of party. Therefore, BJP don't have the support of NCP and therefore they don't have the numbers to form the government. Now the matter reached Supreme Court. In court, Solicitor General Mr. Tushar Mehta argued on behalf of Governor and said that Governor received letter from Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, that means from BJP and from Ajit Pawar, and that letter showed the support of all 54 NCP MLAs. Therefore, Governor invited them to form the government. On the other hand, Mr. Mukul Rohtagi, representing BJP, said that NCP joined BJP and they have the numbers to form government as BJP has 105 and NCP has 54 MLAs. Now, on the behalf of Mr. Ajit Pawar, Mr. Maninder Singh, now the name of these Supreme Court lawyers is not important, but you need to understand the background story. So, on the behalf of Mr. Ajit Pawar, Mr. Maninder Singh argued in Supreme Court and he said that Mr. Ajit Pawar represents NCP and therefore the list of MLAs given to Governor is absolutely correct. That means 54 NCP MLAs support BJP in their government formation. On the behalf of Shiv Sena, Mr. Kapil Sibbal argued in court and on the behalf of NCP and Congress, Mr. A.M. Singhvi argued in court that the decision of Mr. Ajit Pawar to join BJP was his personal decision. That means it was not the opinion of NCP. And since it was not the opinion of NCP, so BJP won't have the numbers. And therefore, they should prove the majority in the House through floor test. Now today, that means on 26th of November, Supreme Court passed the judgment regarding Maharashtra government formation. So as per the verdict, Supreme Court directed that flow test to be conducted tomorrow, that means on 27th of November. Supreme Court also directed that there should be a live telecast and the flow test should be completed before 5 p.m. Now flow test means the Chief Minister is asked to prove his or her majority in the House. So as per Supreme Court verdict, there will be a live telecast of flow test. In addition to that, the court also ordered that there will not be secret voting. Why Supreme Court said that? Because if there will be secret voting, this may lead to horse trading. Now what does that mean? Now suppose there are two political parties, A and B. So since voting is going to be secret, so a member of this political party may vote to this party even if he or she was supposed to not to vote. Now coming back to horse trading means political parties tries to bring the members from opposition party to gain majority in the House using unapproved techniques. Now coming back to Supreme Court verdict, Supreme Court also directed that a pro tem speaker will be appointed and the pro tem speaker will conduct flow test. Now what exactly is pro tem speaker? It should be kept in mind that the speaker of Lok Sabha or Legislative Assembly vacates the office immediately before the first meeting of newly elected House. Therefore, the President in case of Centre and the Governor in case of State appoints pro tem speaker to preside over the sitting of House. So usually, the senior most member is elected as the pro tem speaker. Now why pro tem speaker is elected? The main duty of pro tem speaker is to administer the oath of newly elected members. It should be kept in mind that President or Governor administer the oath of office of pro tem speaker, and this pro tem speaker will administer the oath of newly elected members of House. Pro tem speaker will also enable the House to elect new speaker, and once new speaker is elected, the office of pro tem speaker ceases to exist. So it means the office of pro tem speaker is temporary. So as per Supreme Court verdict, pro tem speaker will be appointed to conduct the floor test of House, and the senior most MLA of the House will be nominated as pro tem speaker. So this was the entire case so far. On 27th of November, there will be floor test in Maharashtra. If our video was helpful, please share it. Thank you.